What's up, investors? My name is Art Dieker. In a couple of minutes, you'll know what is a fiscal year. I'll first give you a professional definition and then I'll explain it as easy as I can with examples. And if you want to learn personal finances and investing watching such short videos, please consider subscribing to my channel, liking this video to show the support for the young creator. Many more videos are coming. Thank you so much, let's get straight to the point. Alright, so a fiscal year is 1 year business activity period that companies and governments use for financial reporting and budgeting. A fiscal year can be further divided into financial quarters, and if you're not sure what a financial quarter means, feel free to watch my previous video. And here is an example. The only difference in terms of timekeeping between calendar and fiscal year is when these periods begin and when they end. Traditionally, a calendar year starts on January 1st and ends on December 31st. But fiscal year might be different, especially for cyclical businesses. For example, if a company heavily relies on winter holiday sales, it might choose to end its fiscal year on January 31st and start it on February 1st. As you can see, there still must be 365 or 360 days in each fiscal year. And the reason why cyclical companies might want to choose different fiscal years is to avoid dealing with taxes during its busiest seasons. Fiscal year for the US government ends on September 30th and starts on October 1st. And in this case, a very interesting thing can happen. If there are spendings that are planned to happen, let's say so, on November 18th, 2021, such spendings will be recorded for fiscal year 2022. And the reason for this is that even though we're still in calendar year 2021, government's fiscal year of 2022 has already started. If you want to know when fiscal years of any publicly traded company starts and ends, just open any of its 10K annual financial reports. On the very first page, you will see a line that says something like this. For the fiscal year ended June 30th, 2020. In this case, it means that fiscal year for this company starts on July 1st and ends on June 30th. And if you still have any questions after watching this video, feel free to leave a comment and I'll personally reply to you. Check my other videos to see if there's anything else you want to learn about personal finances and investing. Thank you all so much for spending this couple of minutes with me. I really hope there was something new to learn today and it was straight to the point.